Good morning students, today we are going to conduct an experiment number 3, that is measurement of resistance and inductance of a choke coil using 3 voltmeter method. So the aim of the experiment is to measure a resistance and inductance of a choke coil using 3 voltmeter method. This is the circuit diagram where we are going to perform this experiment. If you look up this circuit diagram, it consists of phase and neutral terminals of the supply voltage having a voltage of 230 volts and 50 hertz, and it is nothing but a DPST switch, nothing but a dipole single through switch whose rating is 10 amperes, and there is a fuse to protect the load and the remaining circuit equipments from short circuit condition as to make the circuit and to break the circuit. And here there is an auto transformer. The purpose of the auto transformer is to provide the required rated voltage, and here a voltmeter V1 whose reading like 0 to 300 volts has to measure the supply voltage, and there is another voltmeter called V2 of 0 to 300 volts to measure the voltage across the rheostat, and there is another voltmeter of V3 whose reading is like 0 to 300 volts has to measure that voltage across the choke coil. Next, connections. If you see that procedure, the connections are made as per the circuit diagram, and here we are going to vary the supply voltage slowly as to meet the rated voltage, and the readings has been taken across the 3 voltmeters and 1 ammeter, and this procedure has been repeated for different voltages as to find the unknown resistance value, inductance, and here. As to look at the video, here if you see the tabular column, in this tabular column, this is that where we are going to tabulate that voltmeter 1 reading value, this is voltmeter reading 2 value, voltmeter 3 reading value, and here we are going to find out that power factor and power across the load. To find out all these values, let us consider the conduct the experiment. So look at the video as to find the experiment.
Good morning students, today we are going to discuss an experiment on measurement of resistance, inductance of a choke coil using 3 voltmeter method. So to measure the resistance and inductance of a given choke coil using 3 voltmeter method, these are the following apparatus what we require. For suppose if you see here, we required 1 ammeter whose current reading is like 0 to 1 or 2 amperes, and it required 3 voltmeters, that is MI type, moving iron type, like 0 to 300 volts, 2 number, and 0 to 100 volts, 1 number we require. And again here we have that rheostat whose rating is like 38 ohms of 1 ampere, and 1 number it is required. This is the circuit diagram what we are going to make the circuit. Let us see the panel board. This is the panel board where to conduct the experiment to measure the resistance, inductance of a choke coil using the 3 voltmeter method, and these are the 3 voltmeters V1, V2, V3, and this is an ammeter, and here it is the choke coil, and this choke coil internal it is there, and this is that resistance. For suppose if you see that connections here, this is the main power supply. The main power supply here it is initially coming to that MCB called miniature circuit breaker, and again it will come to the protective device called fuse. And from here onwards it will come to these tappings of the phase and neutral terminals. For suppose if you see that connections here, this is that phase wire which is directly given to the ammeter of one terminal, and the terminal of the ammeter it is given to that input terminal of the rheostat, and another terminal of the rheostat it is given to the one terminal of the choke coil, then another terminal of the choke coil is given to the supply negative, that means supply neutral wire, and 3 voltmeters are there here. First voltmeter, that is V1 voltmeter, which is connected across the supply to measure the supply voltage, and the second voltmeter called V2 which is going to connect across the rheostat as to measure the unknown resistance, and third voltmeter that is called V3 which is going to connect across the choke coil. So these 3 voltmeters are going to measure the voltage from the supply side, the voltage across the rheostat, the voltage across the choke coil. So now we are going to conduct the experiment. Initially we are going to switch on the main power supply and next we have to switch on the MCB. Once we switch on the MCB, it makes the circuit, and to perform the readings, here we are given the supply to the all meters. Initially all meters are showing that zero reading. Now I am going to apply the voltage with help of an auto transformer. Now by varying the variac of the auto transformer, here we can notice the voltage and the currents. For suppose here I tap a voltage of the supply voltage like 60.4 volts, that is supply voltage across that phase and neutral terminals. Then voltage offered across the resistance, it is 56.7 volts, and the voltage offered across that choke coil, that is 14.25 volts, and the current here, it is 0.119 amperes. So we can do the same experiment for different ratings of the voltage, because here the configuration of the auto transformer, that is the supply input voltage is like that, 230 volts, and the output voltage is like 0 to 270 volts. Now I am going to make a tap of another voltage, like for example 100 volts, I am going to tap at here. So here I am choosing that 100 volts at the supply voltage, that is V1 reading is 100, V2 reading is like 93.5 volts and V3 reading is 24.3 volts and the current reading here it is 0.19 ampere. So we are going to tabulate these readings in the tabular column. Look at the tabular column here. This is the tabular column where we are going to tabulate the values. Serial number 1, input supply voltage, we tab for 100 volts. Then V2, that is voltage across the resistor, like 93.7 volts. And V3, that is voltage across the choke coil, that is 24.3 volts. Next, the current through the circuit, that is 0.197 amperes. Next, we have to find out that power factor cos pi. Here, we are going to use the formula like Vs square minus Vr square minus Vl square divided by 2Vr Vl. So if you find the cos pi value, this cos pi is equal to Vs square minus Vr square minus Vl square divided by 2 into Vr into Vl. If you do that simplification, here we got that 4553, that is 45.53, then current is 0.197 ohms and Z value here V by Vl by I, that means V1 divided by I, that is 507 ohms and R is equal to Z into cos pi, here it is 4823 ohms. Then XL value is 3272 ohms and L value here it is XL divided by 2πf and L value can become as 10.41 henries. That for a given circuit with help of 3 volt meters, here we are calculated that unknown resistance, reactance and inductance for the given circuit using 3 voltmeter method. Thank you.